Let's have a party and drink up a lot of beer.
It's a special holiday edition of the Friday Beer Buzz underway here on WYLK. That's right, we got a whole hour's worth of stuff. We got guests like crazy here in the studio. Yeah. I want to thank Tony Graham in our last segment from Madison. We talked about pairings and so forth and so on. Rocky from KRZ is here. Every Friday morning, you guys do your own happy hour thing. We like to trade
right down the hall,
the beverages back and forth, up and down the hallway. We appreciate that. Mrs. Beer Buzz is here. Yay, Mrs. Beer Buzz!
Okay.
And guests aplenty. A little bit of noise from the guests, everybody.
Guests aplenty. Yes.
They're on their best behavior unless we prompt them.
It's really hot in here.
It is.
Lots of sweat on the video.
It's starting to get a little hotter. That's
next
right.
Next year we're going to wear tank tops in the...
We're doing a special beach edition.
The holiday beach.
Don't forget, of course, the video. You can catch the video online at WILKNewsRadio.com as you can every Friday, Beer Buzz.
And also don't forget, you can become a member of the Beer Text Club. Just text BEER to 99404. Okay, and then you get a little sneak peek about what we're doing each week, and we give away really great prizes.
Yeah, and every week we're brought to you by Krugel's Georgetown Deli and Beer. Bill from MyBeerBuzz.com. Go to that, MyBeerBuzz.com, and anything and everything you ever care to know, you need to know about beer is there.
And then some.
And then some.
Right, right. Exactly. And after every week after we do the beer, you put up what we do, and so many people comment. So
really?
Also check out the video at WILKNewsRadio.com, then go to MyBeerBuzz.com and check in. So many beer buzzers are there.
You can read the comments, and of course you can leave a comment.
Yeah, please do. I mean, we love interacting with people, and we do, I say we as me, I do respond to everybody. I do, you know, people send in questions, people send in comments. I do respond to all the comments. I do answer all the questions, and it is me. So please do interact. We love to interact with
absolutely
people.
And you can see the video on mybeerbuzz.com or on our website, but you want to definitely check out the holiday edition of video, because this studio is decorated like never before.
We've got everything. Yeah.
This looks like the window at Boscov's. It's unbelievable.
It's a little warped, let's be honest.
All right, a little bit.
So we have a beer question for segment 3, and this is something we get asked all the time, and this is something that I will tell you I fly in violation of, and it is, what temperature should you serve your beer at, and what temperature should you drink your beer at?
You mean the outdoor temperature?
the
temperature of the beer.
Yeah, the temperature of the beer. You know, people will tell you that beers have specific complexities that come out at specific temperatures.
Right.
And that beers should not be served cold. Now, I'm the first one to tell you, there are some beers I love cold. Mm. A frosty mug in the summer with a Heffy in it, a nice wheat beer in it, I think that's great, and I think that's great cold. I like to start all beers cold. I hate to say that, because Belgian beers, that's like such a crime.
Uh-huh.
But if you start it cold and let it go warm, then you can taste the variety of flavors all the way through all of the temperatures, not just the warm temperature and not just the
cold. You know, flavors definitely tend to emerge as the temperature increases or comes a little closer to room temp.
And I will not fight the concept that beers, many beers, get better and more complex and more interesting and more flavors come out as they get warm.
I guess it's sort of depending on what the beer is. I mean, I don't know if this is a good question at all or not, but is there an ideal temperature for beer, or I mean, generally speaking, or it depends on the beer?
Depends on the beer. And funny you should ask that. Our beer today should be served at 50 degrees.
Mm-hmm.
So Tom brought it. Tom brought a thermometer, right, Tom? You got a thermometer back there?
Oh, really? Good job.
Thermometer
Tom is here.
Tom, you didn't drink that beer yet.
But it's a little too cool. I'm going to hold it in both hands and blow on it.
Like a kid. Is it there yet?
Yeah.
Is it there yet?
How about that?
Is it now? Is it okay? Is it okay? Our beer comes to us from Placentia, California, and our beer for this segment is called the Brewery Four Calling Birds.
I didn't see that one coming.
No, not at all.
Partridge in a pear tree.
And it's from not the placenta, right? It's placentia.
Placentia.
Okay. Although it has to go there.
Placenta is much funnier. We could go there.
I was enjoying this beer a second ago.
No placenta was harmed in creating this beer.
We just thought we'd put that image in your head for you.
This comes from the brewery, and that is Brewery. Mm-hmm. And it is named after the brewmasters and people that founded the beer, Patrick and Christopher Rue, R-U-E. Uh-huh. So that R-U-E is part of the name of brewery. Last year on the show, we featured their three French hens, if you remember.
Oh, yes.
This is a 12-beer vertical series meant to be consumed on December 24th or 25th in 2019, doing 12 beers.
Wait a minute, let me get my calendar. Make a note on there.
Now,
December 2019.
If we all hang in there long enough, I promise I will feature every one of these beers.
Wow.
They already say that the first two beers in the series are almost impossible to get.
Yeah.
We did three French hens last year. This year it's four calling birds.
Yeah.
It is a Belgian... Did somebody say four calling birds? Katie remembers last year. You got to go back.
All right, Katie.
Please play back last year's Christmas special.
It was great.
And that'll make much more sense.
Yes, and thank you, Katie. Thank
working
our
best. Yes,
producer.
Katie.
Absolutely. You did a great job, too.
This is a Belgian dark ale, which makes sense because this beer has to sit down for another couple of years. It has to sit down for another 8 years, give or take. It is a Belgian strong ale. This one is 11% ABV.
Turn out
so
right.
big, yeah.
Now, Bill, on the Friday Beer Buzz, we always talk about not wanting to get too fancy pants with beers.
Yes.
All right, that, you know, beer is supposed to be enjoyed. Is this, you know, drinking it in 2019, it's supposed to be paired up on December 24th, that seems to be getting into the verge of fancy pants.
It is, but it's called a vertical tasting. And we've talked about that before, and we've actually done a couple verticals on the show.
Uh-huh.
It, you know,
Stone's got a vertical.
Yeah, Stone does a vertical series called the Epic Series, yeah. And we've done that. They name it after the date. They released the very first one on February 2nd, 2002, then on March 3rd, 2003. So they're 222, 333, 444. They're up to 11-11-11, and they're going only to 12-12-12.
Right.
So next year on eBay, you will be able to spend thousands of dollars to get all 12 beers from Stone Vertical.
And, you know, and what Joe said about not to wanting to get too fancy pants ever with beers, you know, that's a recommendation. In 2019, if you have all these beers, and you're lucky if you do, you can drink them in a vertical series, but you can also just get a bottle of this in a Slim Jim and knock yourself out.
Yeah.
Just saying.
Yeah, we don't want people to think that this beer needs to sit for 8 years. As people will start to taste this, and we passed it out in the room, this beer is very good now.
Yeah.
And
how much better can this get?
It can get better. It'll age. It's a barrel-aged Belgian bottle-conditioned beer. And we haven't talked a lot about bottle conditioning, but that means that they repitch yeast and additional sugars into the bottle, so the beer continues to ferment in the bottle. It's called bottle conditioning. So this beer will change, and it will get better. And it is brewed to be consumed in 8 years. And I think that's a
pretty... Reminds me of the... You know, I'm sure you saw The Jerk with Steve Martin. Everybody's sitting in the restaurant, and they bring him a bottle of wine, and it's like 1952.
Yeah.
Take this wine away and bring me something fresh.
So did anyone notice the error here in the beer name?
The error?
The error, the mistake in the beer name.
Four calling birds.
Yeah.
It's three calling birds.
No.
Four calling birds, three French
hens. Oh, three French hens.
It's not calling. It's actually the real song is Four Collie Birds.
Get out of here.
Oh.
Oh.
I'm not kidding you.
My Christmas is ruined.
I am not kidding you.
What?
Collie Birds?
Collie, and they pronounce it Coley, and...
Nerd!
I'm sorry to break the news, but that is the truth. I'm going to...
You know what? I've been tasting it. I get a little bit of a... I don't know. Am I... Call me nuts here, but do I taste banana in this, or what am I tasting?
Dark fruits, so something like pruny, dark cherry.
Yeah,
so you might get banana out of it.
I also get a little...
some kind of like a nutmeggy or...
Cakey gingerbread thing or something.
Yeah. Cloves.
Gingery?
Cloves.
Cloves?
Yeah, this uses gingerbread. So there's a gingerbread-like spice in here. And we should tell people that Collie Birds are just blackbirds.
Mm.
And the reason that they named the song Collie Birds and used Collie Birds was because in the 1800s it was a delicacy that people ate blackbirds.
And, you know, I guess it makes sense because did you ever really think about, like, what is a calling bird?
Right.
What's a calling bird?
I figured it was something that would, you know, yell out.
But nine lords a leaping, eight maids a milking. Also, I don't know what lords a leaping
is. I thought calling birds like they talked or something.
Oh.
Yeah, well, you know, sing a song of sixpence that ends with 24 blackbirds baked in a pie.
I think we should better drink the rest of this.
Why don't they just call it Four Blackbirds?
I don't know.
It wouldn't fit in the song, would it?
So I'm writing a letter to Barletta. I'm mad now.
As soon as we get off, we're calling the
I don't even know what to think at this point.
So what do we think? Do we like it?
I like it very much.
Great. Yeah.
This is nice. The brewery, BRU, and the name is taken from Patrick and Chris Yu. They're brothers, you
Brew.
Said?
R-U-E. They are brothers. Yeah, they started out, again, home brewing tradition. Chris and Patrick, and I think it was Chris's wife, started brewing an IPA in their kitchen, and his wife's biggest concern was, were they going to clean up the stove after they were done? And now they are multi-million dollars.
Somebody else can clean up the stove.
They just sold out. They have a reserve club that you can buy in for $295, and it gets you this beer and some other special
beers. Nice.
They sold 1,000 memberships in 48 hours.
Wow.
$295,000 in brewery, income, 48 hours.
The Brewery Four Calling Birds, that's our beer this segment here on a special hour-long holiday edition of the Friday Beer Buzz. We'll be back in just a minute on WILK.
Yeah.
Let's have a party and drink up a lot of beer. Let's have a party and drink up a lot of beer. Well, wine is fine, but give me lots of beer. Wanna drink some beer, talk some trash this morning.